that before the service in the church will be meaningful, every member of the church as individual must have contact with God. Your contact with God, you yourself will have been worshiping God daily before you come to church on Sunday. You will have encounter with God through your Bible study, through your prayer, through whatever you are doing. So when people come together on Sunday, so we are talking about people who have gotten revelation and knowledge of God. So everyone will now come down on Sunday together with the revelation and knowledge of God as they come together on Sunday to be blessed by God, to be used of God. The power of God will be released through unto them. The power of God will be released in the body of Christ because every one of them, they have been seeking God. So it will not be, the Bible say, iron sharpeneth iron. It means that every one of us, every one of them have been filled with the power of God. So by the time they come together on Sunday, the power of God will mix together and the glory of God will come down. But today, we have Yeye Christian, on serious Christian. So when you have only one Christian in the body in the church, and you have 1,000 Yeye Christian, on serious Christian, what do you expect? Only one out of 1,000, only one person will do whatever he can do. But what of the others? The other remaining people who never seek the Lord, who never seek the face of God, and they still want the move of God, how will it happen? How will it happen? Because you are not in tune with God. And if you are not in tune with God, it will be very, very difficult for you to bring down the glory of God. Even your understanding of God will be what? Will be impeded. If you are not serving the Lord, if you are not serving the Lord as you walk with Him daily, if your daily walk with God is not good, there's no way you can your coming to church will have positive impact, will spark the move of God, will spark the fire of God in the body of Christ. So we have a lot of unserious people in the body of Christ today. Whose unseriousness is affecting the body of Christ? Unserious member, unserious choir leader, unserious Sunday school teacher, unserious member who are ill. We can say they are irresponsible member of the body of Christ. And because they are irresponsible member of the body of Christ, that's why things not going supposed to go. They said in the past that disciples, when they prayed together, the place where they are praying was shaking. It is not on that day that the place began to shake. The shaking has been taking place when each of them has been relating with God individually. And when they come together, their relationship with God will spark fire. Hallelujah. May God help us in Jesus' name. I want us to pray. Say, Father, help me to understand you. Help me to draw closer to you, O God. Help me to relate with you. Let the body of Christ, let everyone that, the Bible says, let everyone that calleth upon the name of the Lord, let them depart from their iniquity. Say, Father, help me, O God, to depart from anything that will not make me to understand you. Help me to depart from it. Help me, O Lord, to understand you. Help me, O Lord, to walk with you. Help me, O Lord, to do your way. In the name of Jesus Christ. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. O Lord, our God, we have come unto you today. We know you are our God, that you deserve all the glory, you deserve all the honor, you deserve all the adoration. Because you are, and you continue to be. You are unchangeable changer. Father, we pray today, O God, as we learn about the revelation of Brother John, help us to catch the revelation of your power. Help us to catch the revelation of your goodness. As we catch this revelation, help us so that our lifestyle will improve. Our way of life will improve. Let